The brute force algorithm that we have seen in the last lecture to solve weighted interval scheduling problem. What is the running time complexity of this algorithm? It is exponential, okay? Because it will take exponential recursive calls, right? So this is exponential algorithm. Can we do it better? Yes, we can do it better using memoization. Okay, sorry. Using memoization now. How? So, remember what we have discussed? We are saying that if you need to compute anything again and again, why not store it for the first time when you have computed it? And anytime further, whenever you need this particular value, just have a table lookup. Okay, so that's why that's what we will do here. We'll use memoization technique. In memoization, what we have to store, so that is also important to identify what you want to at the end. So we want the maximum weight of any job j. Okay.
So suppose mj contains the maximum
weight that can be possible for the optimal solution till job j. Okay, so just make a global array, okay, of size j, so or n, where n is the number of jobs. Okay, so suppose in input again we are having the same thing, number of jobs n, their start time, finish time and their weight. We will sort the job by their finish time and compute p dot. Right. So these steps are same as previous or as our brute force algorithm. The only difference is now we will use the memoization technique. In this, we will make an array of n size and we will say that all the elements of this particular, n plus one size. So we will make an array of n plus one size. Okay, where m of 0 is 0 and m of 1 to n we will keep as empty. Okay, so this is what written here. From 1 to n we have to insert empty, and at 0th location we will insert 0. So we are saying if there are 0 jobs, then the maximum value it has is 0. Okay. Good. Then we have to compute the optimal solution. So the version has compute optimal solution of j. We have annotated it with m. So now it is, because we are using memoization version of we are proposing memoization version of the algorithm. We can replace it with m compute opt. Okay. Now this line is same. If j is 0, means if there are no jobs, then return 0. Okay. Now basically, what are the possible values at this location? This could be 0. It is 0 if there are no jobs. It can be non-empty. What do we mean by non-empty? Means there is some value. If there is some value, means we have already computed it. Right. So if mj is not empty, then return that value. Means you have already computed it, no need to compute, just return from here. If mj has empty value, means we have not done any computation for this value. So in that case only we need to do computation, and the computation is same. You have to find the maximum of when take this job and when leave this job. Okay, so basically you have to do two recursive calls, one to pj, one to j minus one. These two recursive calls, they will get you the maximum value. Just select the maximum value and return the value. Importantly, before returning, just store it in your table. Okay, so you have to store it in the table also. Okay. What is the complexity of this algorithm now? So it is same algorithm, it will solve the exact same problem, but in much more efficient way. Okay, so what is the complexity? Now there is a huge or significant improvement in the running time complexity. We have reduced the complexity from exponential to order of n log n. How n log n? See, when you so sorting, so what is the first step? Sort them by their finish time. It will take n log n. To compute p dot, it will take order n if you sort it by starting time. Okay, I will make a separate video on why it is taking order n time. Okay, but for the sake of completing this particular algorithm, just believe me, okay, that it will take order n when we sort it by the start time as well. Okay, now what is the time to compute the optimal solution? So how much time this algorithm will take, this particular algorithm? In this case, basically these are the constant time operation. Okay, just few checking. Okay, so let me just remove this annotation to make it clear. Now how much time this is taking? This is constant time. Okay, constant time, constant time, constant time. The only computation that we have to do is this, and in this also you just have to do two recursive calls and that's it, right? So it will also take order one. Okay, either we will return the existing value or we will fill the value by just having two recursive calls. Okay, so here we are computing for j. Okay, we will not include the computation cost of pj and j minus 1. That cost will be included when we do actually for this. Okay, agreed. So for job j, you just have to call this and this, which is a constant time operation. Now computing this again will have a constant time operation. Okay, so we will put that cost here. Right. So overall complexity is order n log n. Sorry, it is not visible. Maybe the overall complexity is n log n if you have to do pre-processing. Pre-processing means if you have to do sorting by the finish time, okay, or the start time. If pre-sorted start and finish time is given, then the complexity is even reduced to order n. Okay, so this is the efficiency we can get using dynamic programming. Okay, now till now we have found the optimal solution of n. Okay, what is optimal solution? It is the value, optimal value. Okay, and this algorithm, whatever we have done till now, it is showing that I don't bother which jobs you are picking up. One thing I would like to say is the optimal value of the solution is this one. Okay, now if you are interested in finding the solution, which we are in this particular case, because we have to select the actual jobs. Okay, we don't want to say that, okay, this is the optimal weight which we can achieve. Along with that, we also have to give the solution that these are the jobs which are giving this weight. So please allow these jobs to execute. Okay. So to find a solution, okay, what you have to do? So we have already computed the optimal value. Okay, so using dynamic programming, we have computed the optimal value. If we want optimal solution itself, then after computing this optimal value, just do a post-processing. Okay, what is that post-processing? So this line is very important. This is that we already run the algorithm that we have discussed. We have already have the maximum value or the optimal value. Okay. Then we will run the find solution algorithm. What find solution algorithm is saying, again, if j is 0, means if there is no job, then don't output anything. Else if, okay, if vj plus mpj is greater than mj minus 1, then print j, means you are going to take j and then call find solution for pj because we are taking j. If this is less, then find solution for j minus 1. Okay, so have a look at this carefully. So in this case, we are just printing it. If you don't want to print, you can store it in some array or anywhere. Okay, so finding solution is very, very easy. You just have to have that table lookup, and for each and every job, just decide that whether we have selected this job or we have ignored it. We have selected that job if this particular value is greater than this particular value. So two table lookup will give you whether you have selected the job or you have ignored the job. Agreed? So in order n, you can find the solution also, okay, which jobs you have to select. Okay, now a very, very crucial concept is this. Here we are doing recursive calls. Okay, in this case we are doing recursive calls. Now remember one thing. So this is called top-down approach. Okay, we are starting from top or higher values, and then we are going down in the recursive form, right? What if we can apply bottom-up approach? See, because in the end we want optimal solution for n, and we know that to find this solution in dynamic programming, we need to compute all possible solutions which for all the n's which are less than this. So why not start with 0, 1, 2, and go on and build the solution for n? Okay. So this is that algorithm. Same algorithm, same concept. The only difference is now we are computing the initial things first, okay, or the lower jobs or the lower index job first, and then eventually we can get for higher index, right? So this is called iterative. So that is a recursive version of the algorithm. This is the iterative version of the algorithm. So what we are saying, this line is same, the input is same, okay? So we will sort it, this is also same, and compute this. The pre-processing part, this is the pre-processing part, okay? Pre-processing is same in both the cases. In the previous case, we have used recursive method to solve compute optimization. Now we are using iterative method. Okay, so what we are saying, that let's keep m0 as 0 because it is definitely 0. If there are no jobs, then the value is 0. Then run a loop from 1 to n. Okay, so what if there is only one job? What if there is only one job? Okay, in that case we will, so if we are having one job, then what is the value of that job? Okay, suppose x is the value, and then we will compute m of pj. What is pj for one job? If there is only one job, then p of 1 is 0. Okay, so m of 0 is 0, and this is also give us 0. Fine, because j is 1, there is only one job, so 1 minus 1 is 0. So what is the maximum of this? It is x. So if there is one job, we will, or let's call it v1. Okay, so what we will put here, we will put v1. Okay, then we will run the loop for second job. Suppose we are having two jobs now, 1 and 2, so we will run the loop for the second time. Now in the second time, what we will say, that okay, v2 plus mpj, if one is compatible. Okay, depending upon all those situations, we have already computed p1, p2, everything. So depending on that, now you just have to do table lookup. So instead of going from top to down, we are going bottom to up. Okay, and the advantage of this method is, whenever you want to have this computation, the values are already there. The values are already there in the table. Okay, so this is the beauty, and there is no recursive calls, because recursive call unnecessary, you know, overload the stack. So there are activation records that need to be created when the recursive calls took place. So even we have seen the running time of that algorithm is n log n, the running time of this algorithm is also n log n, but still there is a huge time difference if you run it in the iterative way or in the recursive way. Okay, in this case, there is no activation record creation, no deletion, nothing. Okay, no recursive call. So recursive call itself is taking too much time. So better to use this particular way. Okay, and this is how it is done. So this is an example of how bottom up approach will work. So we will I will show you this example, and then we are done with weighted interval scheduling. Okay, so let's assume that we are having these six jobs. Okay, and these are the weights. So these are the weights which are associated. These are the values. Okay, VJ. So these are the values which are associated with each and every job. Okay, now pre-processing we have to do. So in pre-processing, suppose we have already sorted them in ascending order of their finish time. Okay, so job one is finishing before job two, which is finishing before job three. So we have already sorted them with their finish time, and we have to compute P. Okay, so we have already computed this. What is P? P1? P1 is 0. Okay, what is P2? P2 is 0 because there is no jobs here. What is P3? P3 is 1. Okay, because the latest job which is compatible with P3 is P1 or the 1. Okay, job 1 basically, sorry. Then what is P4? P4 is again 0 because there is no jobs which are compatible with this. What is P5? P5 is job number 3. Okay, and P6 is also job number 3. Okay, so we have computed this value. Fine, good. Now, this is our array memory, memoization technique. So M0 we have already filled with 0 because if there is no jobs, then nothing will happen. If there is only one job, say 2, which is having weight 2, so this is the maximum weight which we can achieve. Okay, now comes the interesting part. Suppose we are having 2 jobs. Okay, suppose we are having 2 jobs, 1 and 2. Which job to select to get the maximum weight? Obviously job 2. Okay, because if we select job 1, then we get weight 2. If we select job 2, we will get weight 6. Okay, but how to do it using our algorithm? So our algorithm says, okay, that you have to compute optimal solution of PJ, okay, add weight of J job. Okay, so this is one value you have to compute. The other value you have to compute is optimal solution till J minus 1, and whatever is the maximum, okay, just select that, right? So let me compute both of these things for you. What is VJ? So right now J is 2. Okay, what is VJ? Value of J is 6. What we have to add? Optimal solution of PJ. PJ is 0. Okay, for P2 is 0, right? So 0 is added here. Okay, and what is the optimal solution till J minus 1? So J is 2, J minus 1 is 1. Optimal solution till 1 is 2. Okay, so now select maximum of these two values, which is 6. So write 6 here. Okay, now let's run our loop further. Now we are having 3 jobs instead of 2. How to compute this third job? So when we are having 2 jobs, the maximum weight we can get is 6. Okay, so what is J minus 1? J minus 1 is 6, right? Because now J is 3. So J minus 1 is 6. You just have to look up at J minus 1 location. That's it. And what is if we select 3? So if we select 3, we will get this value. Okay, because job 3 is having 3 weight plus optimal solution of PJ. Now remember, PJ is having one compatible job, that is job number 1. So we can take job number 1 as well. Now you have to go to this location. Okay, so you have to calculate M of PJ. What is PJ? PJ is 1 in this case. So you have to go to this location. What is the value at this location? It is 2. Okay, so replace this with 2. So 2 plus 3 is 5. Okay, so if we select job 3, okay, so manually also we can see, if we select job 3, we can select job 1 as well, which will give us 5 weight. But if we will not select job 3, then the weight is 6. Okay, so better to go for 6. So in this also we will go for 6. Okay, great. Now we are having 4 jobs. Okay, now jobs are 4. So you know we are having 4 jobs. Again calculate. So previously till 3 jobs we can get maximum 6 weight. If we select job 4, then we can get 7 weight plus what is another job compatible with this is 0. Okay, there is no job, so you will not get weight, but still we are getting maximum if we select 4. Okay, so we will write 4 here, 7 here instead of that. Okay, then our jobs become 5. Now what to do? If we select 5, okay, so till 4 we are getting maximum 7 weight. If we select 5, then we are having 8 value of that weight plus what is this 3. Okay, so we have to go at what is PJ here, 3. So we have to go at M3 location. What is the value of M3 location? It is 6. Okay, so we have to write 6 here, and 6 plus 8 will give us 14, and maximum of 14 and 7 is 14 definitely. So we will write 14 here. Okay, now have a table lookup. So if we will select job number 5, we can select job number 3 also, and maybe no. So if we select job number 5, we can select job number 2 as well, which will give us 14 weight. Okay, this is how it will work. Okay, if we are having 6 job, whether to take this job or not, how to decide? Whatever maximum weight we can get till job 5, it is 14. Okay, if we select job 6, then we will get 1. But if we select this, we cannot select 5, 4. Okay, these two jobs we cannot select because these are incompatible with 6. So we have to select job number 3. Okay, so just you have to see what is the maximum value at job 3, which is 6 again. So the overall value we get is 7. So if we select job number 6, the maximum weight is 7. But otherwise, if you leave it, you are getting maximum 14. So you just keep it. Keep 14 there. Okay. And this is how we will fill our table. Okay. So the maximum.